Hey guys, it's Howitzer here, and welcome back to Skyrim. I hope everybody's having a fantastic day or evening. When we last left off, we were actually not here, of course. We were up on top of the throat of the world, way up there. We just finished off with that quest with Alduin, fighting him for the first time, but now we have to go talk to the Jarl of Whiterun. So, off camera, I went back to the Elysium Estate because we had a bunch of gear to drop off and I needed food and all sorts of stuff. I still need to pick up some food while we're in here, but now that we're here, we're going to run inside, grab a bite, and then we're going to run up and talk to the Jarl and see what we can do about capturing a dragon in Dragon's Reach. Oh great, we got vampires. Look alive, boys. Hey, right behind you. Where are you going? Come on. Get him, boy. Man, he tore me up. Get him, guys. Let me in there, Adrian. Okay, never mind. You guys take him. Where's the other guy at?
Hey, watch it.
Hey, you watch it. We got business to take care of here. Okay, that's a Nord. Let me guess. You're the one? Is that it, guys? Nice. Nice. We didn't hit anyone we weren't supposed to. Or at least we didn't this time. As far as you guys are seeing on camera. Those are so annoying when you come into town and accidentally hit a guard. Oh, wow. Look at all this stuff. Take all that. Take the dust. And wasn't there? Yep. Tomato. Okay, let me get my town gear on.
A few seconds for my supper is all I ask.
And let's check and make sure that we don't have vampirism starting up. Nope. Okay, then let's go buy some food. Nothing else to fight out here? Let's head up to Dragon's Reach and go see what the Jarl has to say. I'm gonna get a blessing from Talos here.
We are unworthy, sir.
And I'm not gonna leave another weapon. My sword's still there.
My axe is yours.
If I do, the guards will just wonder why I'm leaving stuff anyway. Okay, let's head inside. Yep, the Jarl's here. Hello.
May the gods watch over your battles, friend.
Oh, I guess I still had a bounty I could collect from this guy. The giant at Bleakwind Basin is dead.
Excellent. You've done us a great service. Here's your reward.
And I need your help. I need to trap a dragon in your palace.
I must have misheard you. I thought you asked me to help you trap a dragon in my palace.
You know, I wouldn't ask if it wasn't important.
Of course. You already saved Whiterun from that dragon. I owe you a great deal. But I don't understand. Why let a dragon into the heart of my city when we've been working so hard to keep them out?
The threat is worse than you know. Alduin has returned.
Alduin? The World Eater himself? But how can we fight him? Doesn't his return mean it's the end times?
I'm the Dragonborn. It's my destiny to stop him.
I don't know about such things, but I heard the Greybeard summon you. That's good enough for me.
The Nords don't like
now
him,
what's this nonsense about trapping a dragon in my palace?
It's the only way to find Alduin before it's too late.
I want to help you, Dragonborn, and I will. I need your help first. Ulfric and General Tullius are both just waiting for me to make a wrong move. Do you think they will sit idle while the dragon is slaughtering my men and burning my city? No. I can't risk weakening the city while we are under the threat of enemy attack. I'm sorry.
What if you didn't have to worry about any enemy attack, though?
Then I would be glad to help you with your mad dragon-trapping scheme, but getting both sides to agree to a truce will be difficult at this point. The bitterness has gone too deep. Maybe. What of the Greybeards? They are respected by all Nords. High Hrothgar is neutral territory.
Really,
if the Greybeards were willing to host a peace council, then maybe Ulfric and Tullius would have to listen.
Leave that to me. I'll talk to Arngeir about hosting the peace council.
Aye, Dragonborn. Maybe you can stop the dragons and this war into the bargain. Now, if you don't mind, I've got a city to keep.
All right, guys, let's go. We need to go back up the mountain, I believe. Yeah, get the Greybeards to help negotiate a truce. Okay, guys, talk about your runaround. We started the episode up on this mountain and then had to go to Whiterun, and now we're back up here. All sorts of running around. Okay, so where's Arngeir? Hello.
Dovahkiin.
Where's Arngeir at? Oh, here he is. I went right by him. Arngeir.
Alduin, we heard the dragon run shout from here. You defeated him?
Yeah, but he escaped. I need to find his portal to Sovngarde.
I feared as much. I thought it was him we saw flying east after your battle.
I need your help. I need to capture him.
We are not warriors. What is overlooked in the Dragonborn is not permitted to any other followers of the Way of the Voice.
I'll worry about capturing the dragon. I just need your help stopping the war.
You misunderstand our authority. The Greybeards have never involved themselves in political affairs.
Yeah, but the Jarl won't help me while the war goes on.
I see. The dragon will lead you to Alduin, but without the Jarl's help.
Both sides respect you guys. They'll listen.
Partanax has made the decision to help you. This is the road we have to walk. Even the Greybeards must bend to the winds of change, it seems. So be it. Tell Ulfric and General Tullius that the Greybeards wish to speak to them. We will see if they still remember us.
So where did Alduin go?
The old tales say that he can travel into Sovngarde to devour the souls of the dead. You must find out how he does this before he regains his strength and returns. Wind, guide you.
Okay, so now it looks like, let's see. Get the Greybeard's help in negotiating the truce. Talk to Ulfric and Tullius. Okay, let's get out of here, guys. We've got a ton of traveling to do. Okay, we're gonna go inside and get a night's rest. Okay, never mind. Get my gear on. We got vampires. Where are they at? Let's go find them. Where are they? Come on, guys, I hear vampires attacking. Where are they at? Here we go. Okay, now how do I get involved here without hitting the wrong guy? Look how many people are here fighting. Holy cow.
Hold it there. Keep your distance.
What happened here?
Another girl killed. This is Susanna from Candlehearth Hall. Served me a drink just a few nights ago, but I can't say I knew her.
Another? This has happened before?
Susanna's the third. It's always the same. Young girl, killed at night, body torn up.
By vampires? No, he's supposed to be talking to me down the stairs there by the bodies, I believe. Are these murders being investigated?
We are stretched thin as it is with the war. Nobody has the time to spend on this. Not pleasant, but it's the truth.
Could you use some help?
If you want to help, ask some of these gawkers if they saw anything useful. I'm going to examine the body before the rats can get to it.
Okay, so let's check out the vampires first. That's actually what was going on here. Oh, they killed a bunch. Look at all the chickens they killed, man. Vampires are horrible beasts. How could you kill a chicken? And we got a black hound. Don't want any of that. Enough arrows here? Gosh. This was quite the fight. At least I don't see any dead bodies like people that they killed. Since they're usually messing up your game and killing people. Well, some of the chickens made it through. So let's go talk to people down here just so we don't get this quest bugged. Because we all know, or anyone that's played Skyrim, Blood on the Ice is the most bugged quest in the entire game. So let's go talk to some people here. Hello.
Always sad when someone has to die.
Did you see what happened here?
Sorry, I thought I saw a fellow running away, but didn't get a good look at him.
What about you?
Another one. Terrible.
Did you see what happened here?
I heard a scream and came running, but she was already like this when I got here.
Can you train me in dexterity?
Up to no good, are we? I'll teach you, but it'll cost you.
I got money.
The divine smile on a charitable soul.
Nice. It looks like they smiled on it because I just leveled. So let's talk to this person here. Hello? Did you see what happened?
No, sorry. But I did notice that her coin purse was still intact, so whoever did this wasn't after gold. I'm going to keep preparing the body, if you'll excuse me.
Good observation. So they didn't rob her.
They say Falion of Morthal has...
Did you see anything, guard?
Heard they're reforming the Dawn Guard. Vampire hunters or something. In the old fort near Riften. Might consider joining up myself.
Yeah, I'm gonna do the same once we take care of Alduin. Now, I've spoken to all these witnesses.
Just like always. Nobody saw anything useful. Bastards escaped again.
There might be more to this if you let me help.
Look, friend. If you think you can do better than the Legion of Guards, be my guest. You need to talk to the steward, though. We can't just let anyone go around claiming to be on official business. If he's willing, then we'll talk.
Okay. Search Susanna the Wicked.
Shadow scales are all but forgotten.
Take a bunch of stuff from her right in front of everybody. So he wants me saying that I can go talk to your leaf, which is inside. Okay. We're heading up there anyway. Let's go, guys. I'm getting tired. We'll get a night's rest here after we talk to these guys, if they're available this late at night. And it looks like everyone's asleep. You know what? Let's go get a night at the inn and level up, and then we'll come back here in the morning.
Just stoke the fire. Got some fresh baked bread and good cheese if you're after a bite to eat.
I'm looking for a room.
Sure thing. It's yours for a day.
How about any work in the area?
Here. Take a look at this. Some of the Jarl's men came by and left this bounty letter.
Cool. Well, let's get a night's rest here. And I'm probably hungry. Let's take a look. Yeah, a little bit. Let's do the level up while we're here. So we're at 310 health, 330 magic, 240 stamina. I'm going to do another health. And let's see, we've got 2 points. So where do we want to put these? Now, alteration is the flesh spell, so I could easily boost that. Smithing is still horrible. I wouldn't mind doing more smithing. Let's go ahead and take this one. Just because I wouldn't mind getting them all done. Oh, corundum. Here we go. Let's do them both. Now we can actually improve some of the stuff we've got, hopefully. Okay, got that done. Let's go see what old Ulfric has to say. And actually, we need to talk to this guy too, don't we, Yorleaf?
By Shaw, yep. Is that Azura's star? How did you come to possess such a rare treasure?
I found it on the ground. I've heard about these murders.
These are difficult times indeed, when men stalk their brethren like beasts. My men are stretched thin as it is. If you offer your aid, I gladly accept. The guards will be told to assist you as necessary. I'm happy to lend a hand as much as I can as well.
Nice. Okay, so does he have anything else?
The Greybeards have summoned the Dragonborn to High Hrothgar. Such a thing has not happened for hundreds of years.
Excuse me.
Only the foolish or the courageous approach a Jarl without summons. So I know you.
I have a message from the Greybeards for you.
It's about time they turned their gaze from the heavens back to our bleeding homeland. What do they want?
They want to negotiate a truce until the dragon menace is dealt with.
I have the greatest respect for the Greybeards, of course. And the dragon attacks are a growing plague. But the political situation is still delicate. Not all the Jarls are fully committed to supporting me as High King. I can't afford to appear weak. I can't agree to this unless Tullius himself will be there.
He hasn't agreed just yet.
I can't agree to any peace council until I know Tullius will be there. The other Jarls could take that as a sign of weakness.
Tullius is the one who's going to look weak if he refuses, though, not you.
You're right. Let Tullius be the one to insult the Greybeards by refusing their summons. Show up these Imperials for the foreigners they really are.
So you'll come to the council?
Yes. I'll give Tullius one more chance to quit Skyrim with his tail between his legs.
That's what we need, boys. Let's get out of here. Okay, let's head up to the Blue Palace. Okay. We got vampires. They have been everywhere lately. Come on, vampire. Help me out here, guys. I'm not sure which ones are vampires and which ones are guards, and it's just a nightmare. Whoa! Whoa! Time to heal, time to heal. Come on, die. Heal. Heal.
Not like this.
Come on, heal. Come on, come on. Help me out here, boys. Oh, they're busy, aren't they?
No one.
Man, this guy's tough. Oh, is that it?
You're not afraid you'll set fire to something?
Jeez, I'm afraid I'm just gonna die. Okay, are we a vampire? I took a lot of hits. No? Whew. Gosh, vampires are becoming a nightmare. We really need to get going on this Dawn Guard stuff. Ah, here he is. Hello.
Are my men now giving free rein to anyone who wanders into the castle? Do you have some reason to be here, citizen?
Let's see. I have a message from the Greybeards.
The Greybeards? What do those old hermits want with me?
They're convening a peace council at High Hrothgar.
Why, there's nothing to discuss as long as that traitor Ulfric is in arms against his rightful emperor.
We need a truce until the dragon menace is dealt with.
They are getting to be a problem, but I wasn't sent to Skyrim to fight dragons. My job is to quell this rebellion, and I intend to do just that, dragons or no dragons.
Dragons are a bigger problem than the Stormcloaks right now, I'm afraid.
You may have a point. It's getting difficult to even move troops around without attracting a dragon attack. By all accounts, the Stormcloaks are suffering just as badly. Even Ulfric might see the sense of a truce under these conditions.
So you'll come to the council then?
Yes. Yes, fine. I'll come to this Greybeard council. For all the good it will do.
Ulfric's planning an attack. Let's get out of here, guys.
He'd be insane to try.
Whoa, Esbern and Delphine are here. Okay, Molgrim, wait here.
You sure?
Yeah. Fine. Same with you, Hodge. Stay here and get warm.
I'll keep watch from here.
Wow, we got all sorts of people here now then. Come on, Esbern, don't you need to get through here? Hosh, come with me.
I will walk alongside you.
I just want you to get out of the way. Yeah, there you go. Now wait here.
I'll keep watch from here.
Just wanted to get him in here too.
So, Arngeir, is it? You know why we're here. Are you going to let us in or not?
You're not invited here. You're not welcome here.
We have as much right to be at this council as all of you. More, actually, since we were the ones that put the Dragonborn on this path.
In Blackmarsh, tradition dictates we present a potential
mate. The Blades truly knows no bounds.
If it were up to you, the Dragonborn would sit dreaming on this mountain, doing nothing.
Delphine, we're not here to rehearse or grudge. The matter at hand is urgent. Alduin must be stopped. You wouldn't have called this council if you didn't agree. We know a great deal about the situation and the threat that Alduin poses to us all. You need us here if you want this council to succeed.
Very well. You may enter. So, you've done it. The men of violence are gathered here in these halls whose very stones are dedicated to peace. I should not have agreed to host this council. The Greybeards have no business involving ourselves in such matters.
Don't worry, I'll get them to agree to peace.
Peace? I doubt it. They may put their weapons down for a moment, but only to gather strength for the next bloodletting.
You're probably right.
They're not yet tired of war. Far from it. Do you know the ancient Nord word for war? Season unending.
So that sounds about right.
But regrets are pointless. Here we are. Take your seat at the council table, and let us see what wisdom we can find among these warriors of Skyrim. Take your seat, and we can begin.
Okay, let me grab a bite really quick, though. Let's see here. What do I have for soup? Something that can warm me up. Nothing. Well, no chicken soup. Need a bit more. There we go. Lead the way, Arngeir. Pick up the pace, though.
We all wait upon you, Dragonborn.
Well, I'm waiting upon you. You're the one walking super, super slow. Oh, wow. Talk about a power meeting.
Why delay? Please, take your seat so that we can begin.
Oh my gosh, look at everybody's here. Okay, so where do I sit?
We all wait upon you, Dragonborn.
Well, I don't know where to sit.
Now that everyone is here, please take your seats so we can begin.
I guess this seat works, huh?
I hope that we have all come here in the spirit
of... No, you insult us by bringing her to this negotiation. Your chief Talos Hunter?
That didn't take long.
Diplomat.
I have every right to be at this negotiation. I need to ensure that nothing is agreed to here that violates the terms of the White Gold Concordat.
She's part of the Imperial delegation. You can't dictate who I bring to this council.
Please, if we have to negotiate the terms of the negotiation, we will never get anywhere. Perhaps this would be a good time to get the Dragonborn's input on this matter.
By Ismir's beard, the nerve of those Imperial bastards, eh? That I would sit down at the same table with that Thalmor bitch. Either she walks or I do.
That's enough for me right there. That's why I usually side with the Stormcloaks. I hate the Thalmor. So, you're right. The Thalmor have no business here.
I'm glad we agree on this.
Very well, Ulfric. Enjoy your petty victory.
Get out of here, Ellen.
The Thalmor will treat with whatever government rules Skyrim. We would not think of interfering in your civil war.
Ha! Skyrim will never bow to the Thalmor. Unlike your Imperial friends here.
You're lucky I respect the Greybeard's council, Galmar.
We represent the Emperor here.
Sorry, sir. It won't happen again.
Now that that's settled, may we proceed?
I have something to say first.
Here we go.
The only reason I agreed to attend this council was to deal with the dragon menace. There's nothing else to talk about, unless the Empire is finally ready to renounce its unjust claim to rule over the free people of Skyrim.
I knew he wouldn't be able to resist.
A temporary truce to allow the Dragonborn here to deal with the dragons, nothing more. I consider even talking to the Empire a generous gesture.
Are you done? Did you just come here to make speeches, or can we get down to business?
Yes, let's get this over with.
Are we ready to proceed? Jarl Ulfric, General Tullius, this council is unprecedented. We are gathered here at the Dragonborn's request. I ask that you all respect the spirit of High Hrothgar and do your best to begin the process of achieving a lasting peace in Skyrim. Who would like to open the negotiations?
Yes. Let's get down to it. We want control of Markarth. That's our price for agreeing to a truce.
So that's why you're here, Ulfric? You dare to insult the Greybeards by using this council to advance your own position?
Jarl Elisif!
General, this is outrageous. You can't be taking this demand seriously. I thought we were here to discuss a truce.
Elisif, I said I'd handle it. Ulfric, you can't seriously expect us to give up Markarth at the negotiating table. You hope to gain in council what you've been unable to take in battle, is that it?
I'm sure Jarl Ulfric does not expect something for nothing.
Yes, that'd be entirely out of character.
Wait, General, you don't intend to just hand over Markarth to that traitor?
This is how the Empire repays us for our loyalty?
Enough. First, let's be clear. This council wasn't my idea. I think it's a waste of time. You are a traitor to the Empire and deserve a traitor's death. But I at least will negotiate in good faith. Since we're all here at your request, I'd like to hear what you think Markarth is worth.
Okay, so we either give... Not we, because I'm in between. I could care less about either of these sides. A lot of people get pissed off in the comments asking me like, oh, you can't side with the Stormcloaks, they're racist, or you can't... It's a freaking video game, so I really don't care. I be honest, in the past, I usually side with the Stormcloaks because you begin the game getting beheaded by the Imperials. And I hate the Thalmor. The Stormcloaks are just basically saying they're going to kill the Thalmor. The Empire is saying... we don't have the strength to kill him, so we're going to deal with him for now and we'll kill him later. So they both want to kill him. They're both good. I just tend to do the Stormcloak stuff. But anyway, that's beside the point. We'll worry about that if we get to the Civil War. But now we're looking at what we're going to trade for Markarth. And to me, Markarth is kind of a garbage city. And it's not a garbage city. That's totally wrong. What I mean is Markarth has a lot of... infighting and issues going on, and so does Riften. So to me, that's kind of a similar trade instead of the Winterhold one. Let's go ahead and do Riften.
The rift would help secure our communications with Cyrodiil and threaten Ulfric's southern flank.
The Dragonborn has spoken, Tullius. Markarth will be ours. Now we'll see if there's anything behind your talk of good faith.
You disappoint me, Dragonborn. I accepted your invitation on trust in your good name, but it seems you intend to favor Ulfric.
I don't.
I can see now that this is not a negotiation at all. I know you, Ulfric. If I hand over Markarth, you'll be ready with a new demand. You'll never defeat the Empire, and you know it. But you're willing to sacrifice thousands for your own selfish ambition. Soon enough, I'll have you back under the Headsman's axe, and this time there won't be any dragon to save you.
As always, the Empire's fine words are worth nothing.
Stop! Are you so blind to our danger that you can't see past your petty disagreements? Here you sit arguing about nothing, while the fate of the land hangs in the balance.
Is he with you, Delphi? If so, I advise you to tell him to watch his tongue.
He is with me. And I advise you both to listen to what he has to say before you do anything rash.
Don't you understand the danger? Don't you understand what the return of the dragons means? Alduin has returned, the World Eater. Even now he devours the souls of your fallen comrades. He grows more powerful with every soldier slain in your pointless war. Can you not put aside your hatred for even one moment in the face of this mortal danger?
I don't know about the end of the world, but this dragon situation has gotten out of hand. If this truce will help the Dragonborn here put an end to that menace, we both gain. Remember that, Ulfric. Now, back to the matter at hand. You know as well as I do that we can't hand over Markarth on these terms.
Sure's bones! Where will these demands end?
Let's hear it.
We want compensation for the massacre at Carthwaisten.
You slaughtered the very people you claim to be fighting for. True sons of Skyrim would never do such things.
Damned Imperial lies. My men would never stoop to such methods, even in retaliation for your butchery at...
All the blood spilled in this war is on your head.
So, Dragonborn, what do you say?
Ulfric should compensate you for Carthwaisten.
Well said. Once you'll actually pay for your crimes. I suppose that's the fairest deal we're likely to get.
It seems we may have an agreement.
That way at least both sides, I mean, he accused me of being on Ulfric's side, that kind of gives him one to Tullius. Hopefully we're even.
Currently on the table. Markarth will be handed over to Ulfric's forces. Jarl Ismund will step down, and Thangvor Silverblood will become the Jarl of Markarth. Stormcloaks will withdraw from the rift, allowing Imperial troops unhindered access. Jarl Leila Lawgiver will step down, and Maven Blackbriar will become the Jarl of Riften. The Stormcloaks.
Whoa, whoa, whoa! Mavens? Oh, I made a horrible decision. Oh, that's not gonna make Riften any cleaner.
The sons of Skyrim will live up to their dreams as long as the Imperials hold to theirs. What about you, Alistair? Are these terms to your liking? Speak up. I'm sure General Tullius is waiting to do your bidding.
I have nothing to say to that murderer. General, you've proven yourself a good friend to Skyrim. I continue to trust that you will do your utmost to safeguard our interests.
Thank you, Jarl Elisif. I appreciate your loyalty. The Empire can live with these terms, yes, for a temporary truce, until the dragon menace is dealt with. After that, Ulfric, there will be a reckoning. Count on it.
Come on, Dalmar. We have a lot of work to do.
Giving up Markarth is a...
Should I attack everyone in here and kill them all? Let's just end this all right now. No.
Dalgruf, I assume you are familiar with the Dragonborn's plan?
Yes. I'm ready to do my part. Just say the word, and my men will help you spring this trap.
But the difficulty remains, how to lure a dragon to Dragon's Reach at all?
Well, that's an excellent question. You haven't overlooked that little detail, have you?
Ah, I believe I can be of help here. I anticipated the problem. While you were arranging this meeting, I was busy in the library of Skyhaven Temple. An unguessed trove of lost lore. But the important thing is that the blades recorded many of the names of dragons they slew. Cross-referencing this with Delphine's map of dragon burial sites, I believe I've identified one of the dragons that Alduin has raised up.
How does that help us?
Don't you see? The names of dragons are always three words of power, shouts. By calling the dragon with a voice, he will hear you wherever he might be.
Why would he come when called?
He's not compelled to, but dragons are prideful by nature and loath to refuse a challenge. Your voice in particular is likely to intrigue this dragon after your victory over Alduin. I think it's very likely that he will be unable to resist investigating your call.
So what's his name?
Ah, indeed. I'm no master of the voice, like these worthy gentlemen, but it is written here in this scroll. Odavin, winged snow hunter, as I read it.
Okay, so we learned that. All right, let's get up. Okay, so everybody looks like they
There's
are cycling. Oh.
We know about Parthenax.
Turns out he's a dragon, but he helped me.
That's fine. We needed his help. Now we don't. And it's long past time for him to pay for his crimes. And he's not just any dragon. He was the right hand of Alduin. He committed atrocities so infamous they are still remembered thousands of years later. He needs to die. He deserves to die. And it falls to you to kill him. Until he's dead. Well, I'm sorry, but we would dishonor our oaths as blades if we continue to help you.
About Parthenax.
Make your choice, Dragonborn. You're either with us or against us.
Why does he need to die?
Here's the big picture. He helped Alduin enslave our ancestors. He may have betrayed Alduin in the end, but that makes him worse, not better. We can't afford to give Parthenax the opportunity to betray us in turn and return to his old master.
Yeah, that's not happening. I am not gonna kill him. The blades can really just screw off. I'm the one in charge here, not these guys, to be honest. I'm the Dragonborn. You're just a silly girl in a nice piece of armor. That's it. Okay, everybody. Well, this episode's gone plenty long. I just wanted to get all this diplomatic stuff all together in one episode. So if you guys have any questions or comments, let me know down below. If you enjoyed the episode, if you could leave a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please do so for all the Bethesda-type content. Otherwise, I just want to say thanks for watching, everybody. Take care. Have a good one. And I will see you next time.